sea when it's very windy. Of course, inside a coffee house. And to see the waves, for me, it's so romantic and so nice. It's like God actually this plan and not then, alright. Look to your right side. For me, it is just like a Van Gogh picture. That is Europe, right here. Asia is right there. And Africa is right here. Now we can understand the idea of the bridge. That it was hundreds, thousand years before King David and before Jesus. Can you see them? Toys R Us, of course. And the title says Hot Sales. Don't miss it. Super Farm, it's a drugstore. Castro.
It's a 10. Hot Sales, 12. 13. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Example for that, we had a drug queen day in Israel like 2 weeks ago, and it was in Israel, Tel Aviv. For me, Israel kind of Tel Aviv. It's very difficult to do it in Jerusalem, and it was the first raining day in Israel. And you had to see me and my daughter were marching with all the 200 drug queen, and then the sky were open. You have to see 200 drag queens are trying to find a shady place without them. And that was so nice, but it's so acceptable in Tel Aviv. Every week, not during the winter time, remember we are melting near my house. I'm 49 years old and we decided not to bring a child into that world because I saw so many parts of. But it took the British to cross that awful river. But when they did it, most of the Ottoman's soldiers, army, went to Armageddon. They are allowed to do what we are not allowed to do. To your right side, you can see a graffiti. We actually wrote so many graffitis at that time, and the big word said "Slicha," forgive us. Forgive us, mainly because we knew that some parties wanted to kill Rabin, but until today we didn't have something like that, that we actually thought that they are just saying that. Real life, we are going to so many theater shows, and we are going to show many. And to your right side, you can see so many boring cube houses. Those are Bauhaus houses. The UNESCO declared of that street and that city as a World Heritage city, mainly because this style of building, functional building, very straight, are built here. It started in 1939. In Germany, but all the Jews started running away from Germany to Israel, and at that time so many Jews ran away from Europe to here, they had to leave. Then they used this functional architectural style. It's like red cubes, lots of windows because we have sun in Israel, lots of sun balconies. This is the international style Bauhaus. If you ask me if it's beautiful or not, I'm not sure it's beautiful. This is a sandstone, a local stone. From here they build so many houses, and it's so easy to curve, it's so easy to build four stories building. The only problem with that stone is that you can decorate the houses. And you can show off it. But it is the stone that you will see all over from now. And most of the...
No, it's heavy. You lie the ancient history. But all the things are closed. Going downhill, cobblestone. And
And where are we?
Jaffa.
Jaffa.
Ancient Jaffa.
Jaffa.
Old ancient old Jaffa. Place.
Wow. Orange trees? Yeah, see the orange.
But, although we go back 300 years before King David, then you can understand how old it is. I'm staying only with a powerful king, and my king, my Egyptian king is...
Now we're in Jaffa, and that's Tel Aviv. This is a view from someplace in Jaffa overlooking Tel Aviv. It's the Mediterranean beachfront. It just stopped raining and the sun started to come out, so maybe it's going to get a little sunnier today.
Uh-huh.
Beautiful, isn't it?
It is beautiful.
Right? Yeah.
It's going to the bus.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay, you could wave and then leave.
No, it will always be from the right side of the bus, actually. No, not really. From the left side of the bus as well. Now you're going to see it from the left part of the bus. Equal rights. Can you see it? Look to your left. Look to your left.
It's not a bird.
Books.
It's awfully big.
You have the best lighting.
Best lighting, yeah. I have the filet of sole. It looks fabulous. It's
yeah, that's
big.
A wonderful piece of fish. Well, they're going to take the bone out and it'll get a lot smaller.
Are they going to take the bone out?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
Here he comes.
Madame, I debone your fish, madame.
Yes, you may. The bone man. That is so cool. That's a big fish, piece of fish.
Yeah.
No pressure.
No, he's good.
Look at that.
Oh my God, how amazing is that? Wow, look at that. Ah, this is small.
Oh, the one hour.
The whole bone. Thank you.
Oh, wow.
Perfect. Isn't that neat?
This triangle going up all the way to Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, and Egypt. The Gaza Strip is in this corner, southwest of Israel, and the West Bank, if you see here, all these yellow and gray and white spots here go around like a kidney. Jerusalem and down here. This is the West Bank, or what used to be the West Bank. It is called the West Bank because it is on the West Bank of the Jordan River. In Israel, if you declare yourself multi-religious, Friday you stay home because you're a Muslim, Saturday because you're a Jew, and Sunday because you're a Christian. It's not a bad idea. Not a bad idea at all. Anyhow, this is the entrance to the city of Tel Aviv. Better, most of the houses here are not older than 20 years. Some are a bit older, but the rest, everything is new. Many Jews buy an apartment here, they don't live here. So if you don't live in the city, you don't buy coffee, they'll go to the supermarket.
Love is a place.
these two flags here? Wait here. Come here and wait here. If in case. Okay? Please follow me. Look at this tree. Look at this amazing tree, 1400 years old. The inside of the tree is hollow. And the branches come out from within. You see that?
Yeah.
Branches just come out from within. This tree is 1400 years old. The oldest tree in the garden is on the other side. We walk by it. It is believed to be 2000 years old. This is an amazing tree. Olive trees are so indigenous to this country. They love the trees here. Look, they even gave this tree there a stone crutch. Do you see that? So this is Gethsemane. Gethsemane in Hebrew was actually the place where the oil, the olives would be brought here and squeeze the oil out of them. That is the place you squeeze. Shemen, Semene is oil. Many times when you use in your prayer words of Hebrew, you don't know you speak Hebrew. I'll give you one best example, hallelujah. Hallelujah in Hebrew is, hallelujah is praise. And Yah is God. Was put up by King Herod to create the big plateau. The gate here used to be called the Gate of Mercy. His mother came here in the year 326-7 and she looked around with local guides and they pointed out to her where all these important things happened. Everybody is there and now we all spend your life all about it.
What did they say that they put a cemetery along the wall there?
Yeah, because
to keep somebody going inside the gate.
Yeah, I forget what the word was, but to keep Jesus.
Because
he didn't walk through a
cemetery. Something like that. Maria Magdalena by the Russian Orthodox. Titkadem
otzat. But the church would feel
immune. And people would use this for water cisterns, for housing, for hiding, for store. All this area here, walls of Jerusalem. We are in the beginning what is called the Cardo. Cardo is a Roman name, if you remember who was with me yesterday when we spoke about the military, the camps. Please bring us back home. It is called the Wailing Wall because this is the closest we were allowed to come to the Holy of Holies for us. If you see there to the right, the peak of the Golden Dome, just in
yes,
the corner,
yes,
this
yes.
is oh, yeah. where the Holy of Holies was, and this is why this hall is so holy to us, because it is the closest of the four walls to the holy place. Now, Jews go there and pray and ask for anything as much as they can ask, and God gives whatever he thinks is right to give. This is the waiting room. Ladies would go in on the right side here. Gentlemen go from the left.
Could we go near to the wall?
You can, of course. No.
You're supposed to put a paper in there?
If you want to. You're not supposed to write something on it. Just let us follow four past. Now, if you look up there, on the, above the number five, you see there's two hands. One hand naked, the hand of Jesus.
Sorry.
St. Francis.
I'm sorry.
We reached here the way of the cross.
Okay, then up there
is the cross.
This is the place where Jesus was held by Simon of Cyrene. Station number five.
We have the 20 different...
Station number six. Okay.
It's in Torino.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
Remember
this.
Station number 10, inside 11, 12, 13. Actually, you're standing in front of the Mount Golgotha, of the Calvary. It is in the air. So as we go into the church, you, by the door, make a right turn and you climb upstairs. These stairs are very steep. Please hold the rail when you do that. And you can see it there, the white stone under the glass.
Yes,
you can see that there.
That was actually there.
This is Constantine. Constantine.
There's a
one. Operation isn't the Jewish word because he's still a Jew at that time. And they're washing it in the Jewish way, and then we put a white cloth around. There's no way they could bury him before. Sabbath, so to put them in the cave. We will talk about it. Well, look how beautiful it looks from here. It's a nice photo opportunity here. And out there is the first neighborhood built outside of the walls of Jerusalem by a young man by the name of...
All ancient Jerusalem. A lot of ancient history.
A lot of tourists.
All those King David, King Solomon, up to like... Jesus
2,000 years ago. So everything is like Jesus
dying on the cross.
Yeah. Just remain seated till the bus to get from the United Nations the borders of their country to be. And this has to be decided in negotiations with Israel. So, in general, they are working on it, and they're trying to work it out. Services inside. We are
in this church. I'll talk about it here nice and quiet. This is why I wanted you to pull up the chairs and sit down, because it might take about 8-10 minutes.
Go ahead.
This is the
altar of
Okay. Catholic, the priest. Yeah, these are two priests. She was a nun that was killed in Egypt. She was a martyr for Christianity. When Jesus came back in Mount Sinai, where we remember them in the future. Yasser Arafat is up here.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's actually the founder of Palestine.
Beats, Agi Distorts, Malakai, Turk White.
Muslim money.
Died across the Jerusalem from $5,000 per cross to $5-$10 per cross. For other people, that looks like being, you know, just giving a hard time to everybody. It's not a hard time. We watch our lives, we watch your life. You see the settlement here to the right? This is an Israeli settlement. This is one of the most controversial ones of all the settlements we have. About 4,000 people live here. And it is right smack in the face of Bethlehem, which is a bit to the right. Okay, that's the shrine. You see the shrine? Under that are the scrolls. Yeah, you could Google that. You'll find everything on Google. To your right is the Israeli Knesset. You see the parliament? There's the Israeli parliament, 120 good-for-nothings. Sit here, I vote them in, I cannot blame nobody, just myself. And they just, you know, they do their jobs for some reason. They go in there with blue jeans and come out with Mercedes. I don't know how they do this miraculous stuff. But this is the Knesset, and some things do actually happen. So I'm just, you know, I'm just kidding. But this is the Parliament of Israel. Very important, very dear to our hearts to be able to have self-rule after 2,000 years of nothing. And I want to thank you for listening to what I was saying to you, for running along this long, long Jerusalem is a hard day. Jerusalem Bethlehem Day is a hard walking day. You really did it nice.
Joseph, what you want to do?
tell me, how was your day in Jerusalem and Bethlehem?
My day was awesome. I wasn't expecting it to be so beautiful. It would every minute. Uh-huh. I didn't mind. I didn't mind all the hours of being there. Everything was so interesting. You know what's so amazing?
What?
Jerusalem. It feels like it's ancient, like the real ancient city. It feels and it looks like the same.
It looks like it had its peak in about 1000 AD.
Yes. It looked like it did have a lot of stuff went on inside all those places, the evidence of the streets and the residents up there and all these things. It just kind of like bring you way back in time.
Yeah, like a movie set almost.
Yes, it is.
And like, you know, a movie set of Jerusalem.
Yes, and you know the story is like real. You know, the story sounds like a fairy tale, but this is real stuff.
Mm-hmm.
This is the real thing that we really, you know, experience.
Yeah.
I was really impressed and I was happy to see it. Yeah?
Yeah.
And how about you, Miss Lundy?
Yes, thank you.
It's a pleasure. And may I top up your tea?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
No, you've had enough?
Yeah. Thank you. I was amazed at the site, and it was so emotional to see where Jesus was born and where he died on the cross. It was amazing. It brought it all to life, and I enjoyed it. It was a long day, but it was interesting.
Yeah, you don't have to imagine what it's like anymore. Now you know where everything happened.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing. But
guys, I dated Chelsea Clinton. Me too. The reason that she got married with a Jewish guy, I was, they don't believe me. I'm serious. I'll tell you the story later on, but by the way, the neighborhood on the right hand side right now is not Haifa. You know that in Israel, if you have a town with more than 20,000 people, it becomes a municipality by itself. Okay, so little villages that grew up during the years received their own independence, you know, municipal independence, and that's what you see. This area is called Nesha, used to be once a part of Haifa. To circle the Sea of Galilee in about 25 minutes, only this area, it's the only area that supplies us sweet water. My dear friends, we are in the desert. In case you've forgotten it, look around you. But this place supplies us only 30% of our water economy. My dear friends, look at the desert around you. This is a beautiful green desert. Since the biblical times, King Solomon's tables are here, and as we're passing by, maybe we can still see it with the bus, we can see an altar in the middle of the place, okay? And it will be right here, okay? Pay attention right here in this crack. Yeah, there's like, you know, we'll see it later on. Let's remember, this is the Golan Heights, right? This is the Sea of Galilee. I'm not checking the water situation here, okay? This is Haifa's Bay. Upper Galilee, Lower Galilee, okay? We have the Judean Mountains.
Sorry about that.
Yes, okay. And in the south, yes, in the south we have the Negev, remember? Now the main area is Beersheba, but I'm not going to point it out for you. The Anglo-Saxon tribes, it's England today. Frankian tribes, it's France today. So two things you can study. One, you're all olive trees by definition. Two, you know Hebrew. Makes sense, no? So, this is the first industry, and we ship and we sell those nativity books, as we call them, or the Bibles, all around the world. And the unique thing is that not two Bibles are alike. Even if every spot that England had a navy and a port, and they could, they planted oranges. Why? Vitamin C for the sailors. And you can ship it, and that's what they did. Because make everything from the oranges. To be honest, we hate oranges. Only because of the squid.
My dear friends, the balcony is empty, so we're going to leave the bus, okay? To the balcony onto your right-hand side for a beautiful, beautiful vista point. Please join me up. The only thing that you need with you is cameras. And you'll see it, we have Syria, okay? You have passports, right? So we can jump over to Syria. I'm not so sure it's a good idea, but we can do it. So we have. In my opinion, there are a few things worth seeking. One of them is the Bible. You'll find a large variety of Hollywood Bibles, but they're coming in all the versions. It can be the Catholic version, the NIV, whatever version. Even if they look the same, okay, check the one that you like. More than that, they have all kind of things that you will be explained about it over there. Then we will go to the water. Okay, down to the water, then I will give you the explanation, and only then you'll have some free time. Okay, now about the free time, really, the place will be loaded with people, so just make sure that you're back on the bus on the time that we set. Okay, and that's the most important thing.
Where are we going down to the river?
Yeah, to the desert.
Is there a bathroom here?
Yeah, yes. I think there is.
Oh, look at it. It's pouring out. Oh, my God.
Just in time. Oh, just got here.
Buy one, get the second one half the price. Ahava, which means love in Hebrew. The first company of the Dead Sea products are still the best. You know, people come here especially to put the mud on from the Dead Sea. You can take it home with you. The last thing I want to mention to you is the honey made from dates. When they talk about the land of milk and honey, is what they're referring to, honey made from dates.
It's raining.
Where are we?
It's cold. We're at the Jordan River. It's narrow. Look at how it looks like it's flooded there where the steps are.
So we're at the Jordan River Yardenit, like it says on the shopping bag, the baptism site on the Jordan River, on the Sea of Galilee, on the southern tip of the Sea of Galilee. And we just finished shopping and got all our second for half price t-shirts and books and jewelry, and so I think we're all set. Now we go to lunch.
Oh, yummy.
The pioneers who came from 1917 and on, from Russia, established a new form of a settlement, and it's called the kibbutz. In the kibbutz, a collective, everybody lives together, everybody's sharing everything, no private ownership. Everybody by the end of the month is having the same salary. They don't have a private ownership, which means what's yours is mine and what's mine is yours. Now, I don't know how you say it in English, but do you like, how do you say bullshit in English? Well, it is a very nice and a relaxed place. Together, so I believe that 45 seconds. Okay. Let's all sit down, enjoy lunch. When we're all finishing up, I believe an hour should be enough. Okay, so the next time that you have any intentions of really being Indiana Jones, understand that archaeology looks much more like this than the part that you see in the movie, when he goes into temples and shrines and taking all the glory. Okay, this is how it really looks like. Okay, layers of stones, and the archaeologist's work is really to discover. Find me one person that will leave the synagogue when the praying is on. You can't. Because the Torah book is in front of you, you don't just come and cross it. It doesn't work.
Guys, 2,000 years ago, there is no such a thing as a secular person. Praying and religion is the heart of your life.
Okay, my dear friends, we are in the heart of the village. Why do we know that this is the heart of the village? Because we are facing the synagogue.
Okay, my group. Hugging time is necessary. This building is based upon Jesus Synagogue. Okay? We are seated on the floor. It's in a different color. Is that what they did, okay? And it means a lot of money. So great. Who brings the money over here?
Capernaum is how it looks. But anyway,
it's where
it was
Jesus
worthwhile.
That's a village.
It's the village where Jesus lived. Right?
Yeah, for a few years.
Three years.
And that's where he went to St. Peter's mom. But she was sick. He went to heal her. Inside the house, St. Peter house.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Up, when it
and
had
the story.
They make a hole in the roof.
And
so
she's
to
not
see.
Gonna change it.
Yeah. Well, you know what, you gotta believe in something.
But the Golan Heights today, it's not more than 0.5% from Syria's land. The important thing in the Golan Heights is all the water falling down now in the Golan Heights. This is our water supply of the Sea of Galilee. About moving troops in the Golan Heights. Guys, how long it takes you to reach Afghanistan? Miles, right? In Israel, we're timing or we're measuring our defensibility by the ride of the tank. Meaning that only at this spot, not more than 12 miles, and you are in Syria. If you feel your ears, remember we're pumping down. Yeah. Okay. Guys, thank you very much.